So we have very basic questions. Our questions is, what about status quo ante? When will that be established? What about the disengagement that's happening? And if it is disengagement, why is Hot Spring, Gogra and Debsang seeing Chinese occupation? Why did we move away from the Kailash range, giving up our biggest bargaining chip? Why did we build the buffer zone in our old territory and shifted the post back from finger four to finger three? We also want to ask that in your talks with China, did you bring up the fact that because of the aggression that they shown in the Galwan Valley, they single-handedly broke the peace accord, the peace agreement? We also want to ask, why has the Mountain Strike Corps been disbanded? We want to ask, why was a senior minister in the government of India, did he say that India is the aggressor? And is this not against our own interest? And what action has been taken against him? And if no action has been taken against him, which prima facie it hasn't been, does the government of India subscribe to his views? Because this is absolutely anti-national. It could be seditious, actually. And we also want to ask, what is the established policy as far as the families of these war veterans are concerned, as far as the families of these 20 martyrs are concerned? And have that been followed to the T? Because many, many disturbing stories are coming from there, how they're finding it very tough to make ends meet. And in the end, I would only ask the Prime Minister that you talk about chemistry, you talk about your closeness with the Chinese leadership. Have you asked them for any sort of accountability as far as distorting the status quo is concerned? And if not, then what is your chemistry worth it? We only urge the Prime Minister to give up your ego, to give up your love for China, to talk tough, whether it's militarily, whether it's through economic measures, whether it is through business measures. You know, banning apps is not going to solve the problem. You have to hit China where it hurts. And that's economically, that's financially, that's with business. What you're doing right now is misleading the country after you, of course, had the audacity to mislead an entire nation. And you said after the supreme sacrifice